Hello people, many people are asking about what is actually klinefelter syndrome, what is XXY. So here I am going to explain to the best of my ability exactly what the doctors publish in the internet of what a klinefelter syndrome is. And I'm going to move the camera as much as I possibly can to this side here and try and, you know, so one side will be what's actually written, what I'm reading, and the other side will be what problems I have with what's written, you know. So I hope this works, because I'm just manually moving the camera with my hands here. In 1942, a Klinefelter report was published on 9 men who had enlarged breasts, sparse facial and body hair, small testes, and an inability to produce sperm. In 1959, these men with Klinefelter syndrome were discovered to have an extra sex chromosome, genotype XXY, instead of the usual male sex complement, genotype XY. Klinefelter syndrome is the most common chromosomal disorder associated with male hypogonadism and infertility. It is defined classically by a 47 XXY karyotype with variants that demonstrate additional X and Y chromosomes. The syndrome is characterized by hypogonadism, small testes, azoospermia, oligospermia, gynecomastia in late puberty, psychosocial problems, hyalinization and fibrosis of the seminiferous tubules, and elevated urinary gonadotropin levels. Yeah? The addition of more than one extra X or Y chromosome to a male karyotype results in variable physical and cognitive abnormalities in general. The extent of phenotypic abnormalities, including mental retardation. I don't think we have mental retardation. I think retardation, again, is another word which is not a helpful word. And I am certainly not mentally retarded. Yeah. Including mental retardation is directly related to the number of supernumerary X chromosomes. As the number of X chromosomes increases, somatic and cognitive development are more likely to be affected. Skeletal and cardiovascular abnormalities can become increasingly severe. Gonadal development is particularly susceptible to each additional X chromosome, resulting in seminiferous tubule. Let's get off this crap of crazy words that are so scientific the normal person doesn't understand them. The major consequences of the extra sex chromosome are usually acquired through an error of non-disjunction during parental gametogenesis. An error, huh? Of non-disjunction. There's no error in this, if you ask me. I'm sorry. I'm going to go down to the main points here, okay, on this. Yeah. Frequency. Approximately 1 in 500 males to 1,000 males are born with, they say, is born with an extra sex chromosome, so they don't even have the grammar right in the English, are born with an extra sex chromosome. More than 3,000 affected males are born yearly. The prevalence rate is 5 to 20 times higher in individuals with mental retardation than in the general newborn population. I think that whole sentence is crazy. Not very healthy sounding at all. One second, okay?